We'll start with a quote. What is today's quote? If you continuously compete with others, you become bitter. But if you continuously compete with yourself, you become better. So always try to compete with yourself, not with others. A very useful quote. Now, how do you find this paper at the outset? This is a very good paper, better than the one we got yesterday. Yesterday's paper, it was good from grammar point of view. You can check your grammar knowledge. You can get a feel whether you're good at English grammar or not. That way the paper was really good, yesterday's paper. But this paper is really good in the sense from the new patterns, new models, and time taking, the level of difficulty. You can expect a paper like this, more or less. New models, new patterns, and you have to spend a lot of time. If you ask me, sir, is there something that is easy in this paper? I would say without any hesitation, the passage. The easiest in this paper is what? The passage. You can get all the 10, but surprisingly, the passage, all the questions are based on comprehension. Not even one question based on vocabulary. In spite of that, you can get all the 10 correct. And other questions are really difficult. Even for those who are good at English, I don't think they can get every section, they may get one or two correct. Beyond three, I don't think it is possible because of the time factor. Shall we see the first set of questions? What do they deal with? The passage is about what? The Syrian problem and the role of the developed countries or the superpowers like the US, the UK and France. And the writer talks about the solution, his stand. It is a suggestive essay. Some suggestion is there at the back end of the passage. Now, at the outset, generally a passage like this, when students ask me, sir, do we have to read everything in the editorial? Then I say, you have to consider first national, I give the concept sleeps. International, everything you don't have to read. Imagine some problem in Latin America, they're not going to give. But a passage like this, any international editorial or passage, you have to ask a question, what are the implications? What is the impact? What is the magnitude of the problem? Syrian problem, the magnitude is phenomenal. What is the reason? Because of this Syrian problem, today we have the problem of exodus. A lot of people migrate in large numbers. And where do they go? They go to European countries. And those countries, they are not able to accommodate or provide the political asylum to these those who migrate regularly. In that process, a lot of people are getting, they're getting killed, they're dying. Sometime back, we got one passage. Do you remember a child, image of a child near the coast? Remember? So this is a major problem in the West Asia. At the same time, it has got international implications. That way it is an important essay. So you have to decide whether it is an important essay or not. Then you have to read the passage. May not be at the time of the test, after the test, at the end of the session, after the session. But you have to spend some time. That will help you in the long run. So shall we see the questions? Now what is question number one? How many missiles have been launched by the US, UK, and France on Syria? So here, is that the first question? How many countries have been mentioned? Please underline the US, UK, and France on Syria. There are two options. One talks about two contexts. One talks about the US firing missiles on its own, the other together. Now, all of you, please go to line number 81. Shall I read out? On Friday night, over 100 missiles, weapons, 100 missiles targeted three regime facilities. But you have to read the one before that. So how does it go? This time, after a suspected chemical attack on Douma near Damascus, the UK and France. And before that, it talks about the US. So all the three together, they join hands and what is the number now? on Friday night, what is the number? 100 missiles. So which option talks about that? Answer is what? Fourth option. So please, 100 cruise missiles. Question number two. Is the voice loud and clear? Raju. Those are the last rows you have to tell. Okay. Then it's okay. Fine. Question number two. What do Syrians need now? Now, all of you please go to the second paragraph. I repeat, not the first paragraph. The second paragraph, the ninth line. Second paragraph, ninth line. What Syrians need is not, have you seen? What Syrians need is not more bombs and missiles, but an end to the war. So obviously, any country, anyone wants what? Peace. Now, which option talks about that? Fourth option again, an end to the war. Which path, question number three, which path to peace is mentioned in Syria? Now, all of you please go to the second paragraph, go to the last line. There is no other path to peace in Syria. But to understand that, you have to read the sentence before that. So how does it go? For that, now I'll start with the sentence number 15. Have you gone to sentence number 15? That is the last thing anyone wants. The multilateral, the focus of the West needs to shift from unilateral military action. Underline those three words. Unilateral means one-sided military action to aggressive multilateral diplomacy to find an immediate end to violence and then a long-lasting political solution. For that, the US and Russia have to work together under a UN mandate. Now, which option talks about that? Focus of the West on the unilateral military action. He says that should not be that. The approach should not be unilateral military action. Mark it wrong. Future chemical attack either by Assad or by his rivals, not correct. Shift to aggressive multilateral democracy. Please underline those three words. Multilateral, aggressive. Aggressive multilateral democracy. To put a complete end to violence and a long-lasting political solution. Has it been mentioned? The same way or differently? The same wording? Please respond. So what is the answer based on that? Third option is the answer. Now, question number four. Syria's chemical weapons program has been gutted. Please underline the word gutted. Now, all of you go to first paragraph. The line is, we'll start with the ninth line. How does it go? Syria's chemical weapons program has been gutted. Because of what? The missiles. So what do you understand from the context? Failed or removed or eliminated, any of these words. But generally, write the word destroyed. Usually it goes with, write the combination word, fire. The fire gutted the huts. Means what? Destroyed. Please write, destroy, gutted. Now what is the first option here? Syria's chemical weapons program has been failed. Seems right, hold that one. Chemical weapons program has been accomplished. Can you use a positive word? Underline the word accomplish. Accomplish means what? Achieve. That's right, achieve. That's a good word, accomplish. What is a noun form? Accomplishment. Syria's chemical weapons program has been banned. No. Syria's chemical weapons program has been initiated. Initiate is also a positive word. We cannot use that. So what is the answer? Only the first option has been failed. But generally, remember, it goes with destroy, destruction. That you have to remember. Now, shall I move on to the next question? Why is Douma, Damascus, mentioned in the passage? Please go to the first paragraph, the seventh line. This time, shall I read out? This time, after a suspected chemical attack in Douma near Damascus, the UK and France joined hands with the US to punish Mr. Assad's regime. Now, which option talks about that? We'll see each option. Option one, on Friday night, 100 missiles have been targeted in Douma, Damascus. Is it right or wrong? Douma's chemical attack has been gutted. Seems right? Douma is presiding over a monstrous military machine. But it doesn't come here, it comes somewhere else. Douma joined hands with US and France. No, not correct. A chemical attack has been made by the US on Douma, Damascus. Clearly mentioned in the passage. So what is the answer? The fifth option is the answer. Now question number six. How many times the attack has been made on the Syria by the US? No, we'll see the context, the way it has been mentioned. All of you please, what is the question number? Question number six. Please go to the fourth line. What does it say? This is the second time Mr. Trump has ordered a missile attack on Syria. Two times. Which option talks about that? So what is the answer? The fourth option is the answer. What does monstrous military machine mean? Question number seven, please go to the second paragraph, the 11th, 10th or 11th? We'll start with the 10th sentence. How does it go? There is no dispute that Mr. Assad is presiding over a monstrous military machine. A monstrous military machine, underline that, that has used brute force, underline the word brute, brute force against his own people. His own people. So that means it is good or bad? Obviously bad. Brutal, write the word brutal. B-R-U-T-A-L, brute force, brutal. Brutal means what? Cruel. Cruel, brutal, attack, cruel attack, violent attack. Now, which option talks about that? What does it mean? He wants a meaning. US military power? No. UK, US and France's alliance? No. Syria itself? Douma itself? No. So what is the answer here? The third option, Syria itself, has a mission of Mr. Donald Trump's been accomplished? All of you please go to the first paragraph. What is the question number? No, no, the second paragraph, the first sentence. The second paragraph, the first sentence, how does it go? It is also doubtful if Mr. Trump's mission accomplished bravado is justified. The fact that a provocation was pursued for a second strike within a year suggests that the first one failed to deter the Assad regime. Failed. What is the key word here? Failed. It is doubtful. Right or wrong? Yes, it is justified. No, it is failed. It is doubtful, but a second strike within a year suggests that the first one failed to deter. Same wording. So what is the answer? The fourth option is the answer. Question number nine, what will happen if there is a future? No problem, you can follow. What will happen if there is a future chemical attack by Mr. Assad or by his rivals? Please go to the second paragraph, the fourth line. I repeat, the second paragraph, the fourth line. The second paragraph, fourth line. How does it go? If there is a future chemical attack either by Mr. Assad or by his rivals, the US will be forced to act again. Which option says that? What is the third option? the US will be forced to act again, perhaps more harshly. Same wording. So what is the answer? The third option is the answer. What is the focus being mentioned in the last fourth line of the passage? All of you please go to the second paragraph. This is the last thing anyone wants. That is the 14th line. After that, the focus of the West needs to shift from unilateral military action to aggressive multilateral diplomacy. Please put a star mark this question. What is the answer? How many of you say third option? Raise your hands. That's why I said put a star mark. Please read carefully. What are the three words? Start with aggressive. Are you guys listening?
Yes,
read out. Aggressive military diplomacy. Now read what is there in the passage. Is it military or multilateral? Then is it right or wrong? Mark it wrong. Then what is the answer? The fifth option is the answer. How many of you have chosen the fifth option? Raise your hands. Only a few students. I appreciate those students. This is what we say, taking things for granted. You take things for granted, you assume, but you got to be meticulous. Every word matters. Military, multilateral, when you are under tremendous pressure, you are in a hurry, they look alike. They look alike. So you take it for granted with a lot of confidence, immense confidence. The third option is the answer, but not right. I would like to ask a question. How many of you have got all the 10 correct? Do we have a student or 8 plus? Please give them a big hand. Not for getting 8 plus, for attempting the passage. That is important. What is the reason? This is a very tough paper, according to me. Tough paper in the sense, new models, one problem. New patterns, then the vocabulary, higher level. The context, not familiar. And time taking. You have to start with the passage. A paper like this, you have to start with a passage. Then go to other questions. How many of you have read the passage? Please raise your hands. Seriously? You want me to believe that?
Yes,
yes sir. I appreciate. Keep it up. Every day I expect the same response. Now we'll move on. Questions 11 to 15. These are really difficult, but one or two, based on your grammar knowledge, you can make out what is right, what is wrong. Shall I read out question number 11? Now, before we think of the answers, what is a clue for you in the first sentence? Underline the word "an." And this, the set is related to what? Sync model. For two sentences, you have to select one word which goes with both the sentences and it doesn't change the meaning of the sentence. But here there's a problem. You use the indefinite article "an" for singular nouns or plural nouns? Immediate answer. We use indefinite articles before singular countable nouns. But what is the first option? Is it singular or plural? Looks like plural. Now we'll see the other options, whether we can rule out or not. Norms cannot be used. You have to consider two things here. One, you have to consider the vowel letter. Second, you have to consider the vowel sound. That is also very important. But norms, consonantal sound, mark it wrong. Principles, consonantal sound, mark it wrong. Situation, consonantal sound. Conditions, you are left with only one. But still you are not convinced. Please write the meaning of this word. Ethos means set of values. Set of, set is singular. Set of values of a particular group, related to a particular group, or related to a particular activity. Related to a particular group or related to a particular activity. Set of. Please write one more word. Please write the word ethics. Ethics means what? Values. Please write values. Now the passage, the context is what? What is the context? I told you to focus on the context. Context is what? War. But write a few words. Please write. Political turmoil. political turmoil. There is a political turmoil in the West, that region, in Syria, political turmoil. Also right, civil rights, civil rights. Also right, innocent people getting killed. This is a major problem. Innocent people getting killed. That means what brackets you should write? Human rights violation. Please write human rights violation. Troubled area. Write one more. Troubled area. Now, question number 11, what is it about? An ethos of greed had taken over the government. Context is administration. Second sentence, the ethos at work has been decidedly grim since the pay cuts were implemented, related to workplace. So two dimensions, one is administration, the other is what? Workplace. What, you got the answer, what is the answer? First option, ethos. Question number 12, the old piece of junk, underline the word junk. Junk means what? Are you guys listening? Huh? Junk means what? Right, waste. Then answer the question, these days the youngsters, what are they fond of? Right, junk food. Junk food. That means what? What do they like? What do they cherish? What do they find delicious? Waste food. You have the answer. Feeding and harnessing. Underline the word harness. Harness means, write the meaning, extract. Extract is a better word. Exploit has a negative connotation, but you could also write exploit, positive meaning. Harness generally goes with a positive situation. Extract. Write the combination. Harness the potential. Harness the potential. Write one more combination. Harness the caliber. When you write harness, every time you don't have to write, you can use a symbol. Harness the potential. This symbol here means what? Harness. Next one you write this and write one more expression. The latent potential. The latent. L-A-T-E-N-T. Latent means what? Hidden, dormant, not visible. But this one I'm not convinced, whatever it is. Feeding and harnessing the mules. Underline the word mules. Mule means what? A crossbreed between a horse and a donkey. Please write. Mule. A crossbreed, a crossbreed between a horse and a donkey. Feeding and harnessing here means controlling in a way or using them properly. Troublesome goes with everyday English. What is the first word, first sentence? Troublesome, old furniture, am I right? Seems acceptable, hold that one. Troublesome mules, this also seems right, acceptable. Write the meaning of the second option. Cantankerous, it means adamant, please write adamant, bad-tempered, bad-tempered, argumentative, argumentative, uncooperative, uncooperative. The next two words are, all the three words are important. Please underline the word pandemonium. Pandemonium means confusion, chaos. What is the spelling of chaos? Chaos, confusion. Commotion also means the same. Chaos, confusion, but commotion has another meaning, it is like confusion and pushing also. Pushing, commotion. Confusion, then people push one another. Then we use the word, there was a commotion. And we use a word, please write the word, J-O-S-T-L-E, jostle. Jostle means what? Push. That also means push. Barbarous. Write the word barbaric, R-I-C. Barbaric means uncivilized. Uncivilized. Also write the word savage. S-A-V-A-G-E, savage. Uncivilized or savage, barbaric. Now the key says the second option, am I right? But here I don't think it goes with the first sentence. What is the first sentence? The old piece of junk. Can we use bad-tempered? It goes with persons. Can we use argumentative? It goes with persons. Can we use uncooperative? Perhaps, but not in the real sense. As far as my knowledge goes, the option, the answer should be the first option. What is it? Troublesome. Troublesome goes with old furniture. You can't manage it, you can't handle it. It obviously goes with mules. So what is the answer here? The first option is the answer. I'm not quite sure whether cantankerous has got another meaning. I don't think so. I've cross-checked. I still feel the first option is the answer. Shall I move on to the next one? This is an easy. The first one is easy. Question number 11, easy based on grammar knowledge. This one is also easy based on everyday English words, everyday English context. She unwrapped. You all know the word wrapper, gift wrapper. Unwrap. Wrapper is a noun as well as wrap is a verb. Unwrap means what? To remove, to make something public, open. She unwrapped the paper to what? Please underline the word conceal means what? Hide. Then disguise. Disguise also means in a way hide, but not disguise means not in the actual form. It is like pretend. Write the word pretend. Also write the word F-E-I-G-N, pretend or feign, F-E-I-G-N, feign. Sham also means the same. Sham means pretense, pretend, feign. Now here the word should be positive or negative. Open up, positive. Only one word is there. Which word is that? Reveal. We'll go with that. She unwrapped the paper to reveal 7 gold coins. Seems perfect. His door flew open to reveal a huge furry monster with fangs. This also seems perfect. So what is the answer here? The first option. This is a bit difficult. South of Khartoum in September 1883 under Hicks Pasha, a retired Indian Army officer to vanquish the Mahdi. Vanquish, write the meaning. Destroy, to control, destroy. Now here you have to choose retired Indian Army officer, usually positive or negative? Positive. What is the second sentence? More than one unsuccessful attempt was made to relieve Sir Harry, but his spirit was equal to the occasion. Again, positive word. Dashing. Dashing retired Indian Army officer. Write the word, meaning of the word dashing. Dashing means brave, bold, confident. One of the meanings. Coward. Coward means what? A person who is not brave. Negative word you cannot use here. Audacious. Write the meaning. Audacious means bold. Bold, B-O-L-D. But it has a negative connotation, subtle negative connotation. Don't consider that. Fearful. No, negative word. What is the fifth option? Dauntless. That's a very positive word. Please write. Dauntless. Spirited. Write the meaning. Dauntless means spirited. Spirited. Or you could also write confident. Confident. So dauntless spirit, positive attitude. Dauntless spirit means what? Against the hardship, the person does not give up. He has the same spirit, same determination. Also write the word determination, a person with determination. So what do you think the answer is? Obviously, the fifth option, dauntless. This phenomenon is known as of the floral axis. This is purely based on biology, botany and zoology. Or first sentence is about botany. Please underline floral axis. Flora means what? Plants related. And not that easy if you don't have biology background. What is the second sentence here? The ovary and testes are heaped up masses of red or yellow cells due to a of the cells lining the coelom. But any biology student knows generally here the context is about, what is the first sentence? Talks about? This phenomenon is known as something like opening up, spreading, increasing in number. If you have biology background, otherwise you cannot make out. So let us see the meanings of all these words, then we'll see the right option. First you underline the word pilferage. Right? Pilferage is a noun form. Write the verb form pilfer. P-I-L-F-E-R. Pilfer means to steal in small quantities. To steal in small quantities. Bracket you write maidservant. Maidservant. Write employees. But generally it goes with maidservants. At home, the maidservant takes a little salt, a little sugar, provisions, a little. That is called pilferage. Workplace, some employees in charge of the stores, they steal small, small things. That is also known as pilferage. Is it relevant here? Not at all. Right? Penultimate. Penultimate means what? The one before the last one. Ultimate, last. Penultimate, the last but one. Please write, the last but one. Not relevant here. Proliferation. How many of you know the word proliferation? Means what? Increase rapidly. Please write, increase rapidly. Or grow rapidly. Multiply rapidly. What is cancer? Cancer is nothing but proliferation of cells in a particular region. The same cell or a particular cell or group of cells, they keep on multiplying. That is what we call cancer, proliferation of cells. It seems right, hold that one. What is the next word? Please write the meaning of the word punitive. Punitive means what? It has two or three meanings. One goes with, please write, punish, punishment. Punitive measures, punishing, or corrective measures. Also write, corrective measures. Another meaning of the word punitive, please write, severe, harsh. Harsh or severe. Division. Division is not correct. To a division of, that is not right. So what is the answer here? The third option, proliferation, but that's very difficult to make out. I think we have done with that particular set. Yes or no? Who has got, how many of you have attempted these questions? Oh, that's wonderful. Has anyone got all the five correct? Oh, that would have been a real surprise. Four correct? There are some students, very good, I appreciate them. Now let us move on. This is a real problem. Some overlap is there. I don't know why it happened. Give me a minute. Just relax for a minute. What are these questions about? The previous 5 questions very difficult, based on what? Sync model, unfamiliar context, difficult words. Now this set, what does it deal with? Match 2 columns, you have to match A, B, C, D, E, F. Takes a lot of time and not easy to get the correct pair. Not at all easy. For 2 reasons. One, you have to read, take the first option, check with the remaining, the 3 in the second column. That takes a lot of time. And you have to understand the context. Very difficult. But be prepared. Papers like these, then you're ready for the exam. You should be happy you got a paper like this. Forget about the score, it doesn't matter. But after the session, ask yourself, how to get the right answer? How can I handle questions like these? And am I ready for these questions? And spend some time, then you get confidence. You don't look at these questions, you just ignore, you avoid. Then next time you get in the exam, you're not ready for the exam. That will not help you. I hope it is clear. Now shall we see question number 16? We'll take 1 from the first column, we'll check with the 3 options in the second column, then we'll decide. What is, consider the 3 major sources of resistance, overuse of antibiotics by human beings. This is the first one. It seems to be business as usual. Are they related? Which means antibiotic discharge in sewage is not even being monitored regularly. That does not go with what I've just read out. Given that its burden of infectious disease is among the world's highest, is also not related. So don't consider A. Now I'll read out B. What is B? Even as antibiotics lose their efficacy, please underline the word efficacy. Efficiency. Efficacy means what? Efficiency. Even as antibiotics lose their efficacy against deadly infectious diseases worldwide, it seems to be business as usual for governments, private corporations, and individuals who have the power to stall a post-antibiotic apocalypse. Related or not related? Forget about the meaning of the last word. Seems related. This is the right combination. First, you make a note. What is the combination? B-E. Then you underline the last word, apocalypse. Write the meaning. Apocalypse means the end of the world. End of the world. Doom. D-O-O-M. Doom. Or end of the world. So here they have become inefficient. Still, those who are in the government, the business people, individuals, for those people, the business is as usual. Though they have the power to stop, what is the reason? If they stop selling antibiotics, what will happen? They lose business, so they want that to continue. That makes sense. Now we'll see C. India is yet to regulate antibiotic use in poultry. Underline the word poultry. Now look for that in the second column. It seems to be business. You cannot consider D. Keep it aside. It seems to be business as usual for governments. No, not related. Which means antibiotic discharge in sewage is not even being monitored regularly. Are they related? No. Given that its burden of infectious disease is among the world's highest. But here, the clue for you, underline the word poultry. The first column, it talks about specific. The second column, it is general. Then you cannot consider. So what is the answer based on that? Only one option. Which one is that? B and D. Am I right? Fine. Shall I move on to the next one? Question number 17. 17, we will see. However, lawmaking in India is still largely conducted in silos. Underline the word silos. Means what? In groups. Write the meaning. In groups. Now we'll take this one and we'll see the options in column B. However, lawmaking in India is still largely conducted in silos for further use and adoption more formally by the executive. Seems right, hold that one. As an essential part of the legislative process, However, lawmaking, underline lawmaking, whose job is it? Is it executive job or legislature job? Underline the word legislative process in the second column, E. With inadequate scrutiny and assessment? No. Because lawmaking is always, they are very particular, they never take anything for granted. They do, they scrutinize, they assess, they cross-check, they take the second opinion. They can't afford to be casual. So C, F is ruled out. Now what seems right here? A and E. Please make a note. However, lawmaking in India is still largely conducted in silos as an essential part of their legislative process. Both are related. What are related? Underline lawmaking, underline legislative process. Clear? One option you got, A, E. Now what is B? Legislation and policies in the country are often passed for further use and adoption more formally by the executive. Does it sound right or wrong? We'll see the next one. Legislation and policies in the country are often passed as an essential part of the legislative. This is not correct. Legislation and policies in the country are often passed with inadequate scrutiny. That is also not correct. Now C. Ultimately, the time and effort it takes to undo and resolve the issues for further use and adoption more formally by the executive. Ultimately, the time and effort it takes to undo and resolve the issues for further use and adoption more formally by the executive. This seems right. Hold this one. CE, as an essential part of the legislative process, that is not correct. With inadequate, that is not correct. C. What is the other option? D. Now, which option talks about C, D, and A, E? The fourth option. But it is really difficult. I can tell you, so if you have not got it right, don't feel guilty, don't feel bad. What is the reason? The same question, this goes with polity students, those who do MA political science, or law students. If I give this question to those students, 90% may not get it right. No exaggeration. Within the stipulated time period. Do remember that. How much time do you get to work on this question? Not even 1 minute. Am I right? Practically impossible. So don't feel guilty. Absolutely no problem. Not a possible. You cannot answer a question like this in the exam. So just ignore. Shall I move on to the next one? What is the number? Some problem with the software. Column A, I'll start with the first option. There is a palpable, underline the word palpable, understandable. Palpable means what? Understandable, perceivable. There is palpable fear hanging over the global markets, which are interconnected through pathways due to robust domestic policy frameworks. Are they related? One talks about global markets, the other talks about domestic policy frameworks. There is palpable fear hanging over the global markets, which are interconnected through pathways due to robust domestic policy frameworks. Now the second one, there is palpable fear hanging over the global markets, which are interconnected through pathways, have no new tools left to contain after effects has added to the unease. This seems right or wrong? Are you guys listening? This seems right or wrong? First you underline the key words, palpable fear. You have to, every option you have to select or choose a few key words, then try to relate in the second column, palpable fear. And in the second column, please underline, have no new tools left to contain. Underline the word contain. Contain means what here? Control. Please write control. Usually it goes with contain the damage. Please write contain the damage. Restrict. Also write the meaning. Restrict. But grammatically, it doesn't, the flow is not there, coherence is not there. What is the next one? There is palpable fear hanging over the global markets, which are interconnected through pathways that allow transmission of goods, services, capital, and confidence. This seems right. Are you guys listening? There is palpable fear hanging over the global markets. Take a pause. Please draw a line over there. There is palpable fear hanging over the global markets, comma, or slash, which are interconnected. Now he talks about the global markets. Whatever follows, it goes with global markets, which are interconnected to pathways. These pathways, again, what are these pathways? That allow transmission of goods, services, capital, and confidence. I think it is right. Please make a note, AFP is right. No second thoughts about that. There is grammatically correct, continuity of thought, and practical also. I think that is the only one. In such a scenario, emerging economies, in particular, countries with moderate to high external debt, we'll see this one. In such a scenario, emerging economies, in particular, countries with moderate to high external debt, have no new tools left to contain after effects has added to the unease. But the last part is not comfortable. Part of it is right. Now we'll see the third one. While it is true that most emerging economies are resilient due to robust, that doesn't go with coherence, don't consider. While it is true that most emerging economies are resilient, have no new tools left to contain after effects has added to the unease. This seems acceptable. I'll read with the pauses, make a note. While it is true, pause. What is true that most emerging economies are resilient? Underline the word resilient. Resilient means what? Withstand, be strong, face the hardships. But they should use here, while it is true that most emerging economies are resilient, they have no new tools. But you see the pronoun they. You don't see that, then you cannot consider. Otherwise, this would have been the right option. Resilient, comma, they have no new tools left to contain after effects has added to the unease. Now the last one, that allow transmission of goods, that is not relevant. So what is the answer here? The first option, AF, is the answer, but very difficult to make out. Now question number 19. This is also, I think we are running out of time. Shall I tell the answer or you want me to read out and answer? The answer is the first option, AF, but we'll check whether it is right or wrong. To that extent, we should spend time. The draft payment and settlement system bill 2018 seeks to foster, you know the meaning of the word foster? Means what? Encourage. Foster competition, maintaining its well-established institutional character. This seems right. First of what? Competition. At the same time, maintaining its well-established institutional character. What is the next one? 20. Am I right? In order to sustain women's interest in farming and also their uplift, provide subsidized rental services to women farmers. This seems right or wrong? This seems right. In order to sustain women's interest in farming and also their uplift, provide subsidized rental services to women farmers. Please make a note, AD seems right. It seems right at the outset. The biggest challenge is the powerlessness of women in terms of claiming ownership of the land they have been cultivating. This also seems right. The biggest challenge is the powerlessness of women in terms of claiming ownership of the land they have been cultivating. BE. Research worldwide shows that women with access to secure land provides, that is not correct. Secure land in terms of claiming ownership, this is also not correct. There must be a vision. No. Now we'll see B and F. The biggest challenge is the powerlessness of women. There must be a vision backed by an appropriate policy. No. Now we'll check A and F. Are you guys listening? In order to sustain women's interest in farming and also their uplift, there must be a vision backed by an appropriate policy and doable action plans. I think this seems right. So first you make a note, AF is one combination, BE, beyond any doubt, the biggest challenge is the powerlessness of women in terms of claiming ownership of the land they have been cultivating. So what is the answer now? Fourth option, AF, BE. Now we'll see. '21 to '25, what do they deal with? Double fillers. Am I right? Or triple fillers? Triple. Not a very difficult. I don't know what exactly they expect when they give questions like these. Nowadays, last 16 onwards, they are not testing the knowledge in the real sense. What is the reason? Questions like these, how can you answer in 20 minutes? With the passage. Passage itself takes, if your average speed, 150 words you take, and if you read the passage, because you have to answer the questions, any competitive exam, the usual time, 7 to 8 minutes to read, understand, answer the questions. Now you are left with how many minutes out of 20? Take off 8. 12 minutes reading sentences like these, getting the right answers, not possible. Then you may wonder, why do they give? That is the reason why last year a lot of candidates got zero. English, zero. Do you know that? 17, a lot of candidates, may not be a lot, but some candidates with zero in English, they got selected as SBI probationary officers. Do you know that? How did it happen? Why did it happen? When they gave the notification, they said sectional cutoff. And zero means you cannot talk in terms of sectional cutoff. But 16, 17, the papers were very tough. Many candidates got zero. And they decided, on second thoughts, they decided not to consider sectional cutoff, and they took overall marks. When they took overall marks, it so happened that a few candidates, those who got zero in English, they got above the cutoff, and they got the job. Based on that, some candidates filed a case, obviously. Notification said something. Selection was based on something else. The case is still in the court. And because of that particular incident, next year, last year, SBI introduced sectional timing and sectional timing, I think they introduced, sectional cutoff. Removed? They removed sectional cutoff, am I right? Or it is still there? Some exam they removed sectional cutoff. Which one is that? SBI. So the point here, why do they give questions like these? What do they test? They know for sure candidates cannot answer. Now I find it so difficult to read and explain, because somewhere back of my mind I know I'm not able to reach you people, because I'm doing in English, one reason. Second, unfamiliar context, and I cannot provide the background information. We don't have so much time. And unpleasantness, unease is very much there. Now imagine, in the exam you have to read quickly and answer. Not possible. Then the $1 million question, why do they give these questions? What are they testing? Are they testing English? Or are they testing something else? Please remember. No, they're testing something else. That it's a well, what I say, I mean it. They're testing the stress management skill of the candidates. What are they testing? Stress management skill. When you see questions like this, this is what happened 16, 17. A lot of candidates, they got switched off. They panicked, they got switched off. And they didn't know what to do. They forgot to read the questions also. They were so scared. They could not make out the head and tail of the questions. And it looked like Latin and Greek. But any tough paper, at least a few questions will be easy for many candidates, candidates with preparation. Then what happens? The cutoff comes down. Easy paper, the cutoff 15 marks. A moderate paper, 12. And tough paper, 6 or 7. You should try to get those 6 or 7. That's what they expect from you. Do you understand what I say? But if you panic, you don't answer, then what will happen? You will get how many marks? 0, obviously. Very simple. Otherwise, not possible. How is it possible? Now we'll see. Why I say how difficult these are, for one question, you have to consider three blanks, every time five words. And these words are based on usage. There is no hard and fast rule, you have to use this, you have to use that. If you don't have that exposure to the language, you are not aware of the usage, practically impossible. But we'll give it a try. There are many ways to make in India. What we know is that technology is going to be at the... If you read the newspapers, quite often you come across words like, please underline the word, forefront. Here the context is positive. Rear means what? Back, negative, mark it wrong. Quest. Quest talks about interest. It doesn't talk about the first position or being at the back. Don't consider quest. Mission, that doesn't talk about the position. And advent, it doesn't talk about the position. Helm. Helm means, write the meaning. Forefront means at the beginning, in the first position. Helm means at the top, at the top. Helm of, at the helm of affairs, at the top of the affairs. Now, which is a better word, forefront or helm? Forefront. Now, take forefront. Have they given the options? How many options begin with A? Two options. Now, ignore the remaining options. You have to decide between three and four. Now, what is the second blank? There are many ways to make in India. What we know is that technology is going to be at the forefront of the to create. You have something to create. What is that? It could be mission. It could be quest. Advent cannot be used. Helm cannot be used. So you have to decide between mission and quest. At the forefront of the quest to create. Quest means what? Search, seek, try, strive, all these words. Quest. Quest to learn, urge to learn, urge, interest. Mission generally goes with companies, mission and vision. Now, what do you think the answer is? The third option, AC, what is the third word? E, what is E? But how can India benefit from the opportunities that the advent of new technologies provide? Advent means what? Advent, please write the meaning. Advent of, arrival of, advent of, arrival of, one meaning. Availability of, as I say, some of these questions, you don't have to read all the combinations. You don't have to try. Once you are sure one particular word, then check. You can eliminate two or three options. Then you can focus. Shall I move on to the next question? Question number 22. In its latest World Development Report, The Changing Nature of Work, what is the name of the report? The Changing Nature of Work, the World Bank. This is rather easy. Will you say resultant? Resultant? No. Dramatically. Now, what part of speech are you supposed to use here? A verb. In present tense. How many verbs are there? Examines, seems right. Verifications, there it is a noun. Implications, noun. Evidently, adverb. Only one verb is there. Which one is that? Examines. So that seems right. In its latest World Development Report, The Changing Nature of Work, the World Bank examines the global. Now, how many options with C? CE or CD? Now, the global CE means what? Implications. That seems right. Hold that one. What is the second one? The global verifications. Do we use the word verifications? Implications. So based on that, you can decide quickly what is the answer. The first option is the answer, CEB, right? If you try that way, you don't find them very difficult. You can save a lot of time. Shall I move on to the next one? 23. New jobs will require specific skills. Please underline the word skills. What are those skills? A combination of technological, you may not guess, problem solving and critical thinking, then whatever the word, as well as soft skills such as, again you underline the word skills. Now we'll see. New jobs will require specific skills, a combination of technological, impatient, is it relevant? Mark it wrong. Know-how, if you read a lot, it's a regular expression, know-how of something, expertise, how to do something, know-how. Technological know-how, it's a standard expression, perfect word combination. But we'll see other options. Technological skills, this also seems right, hold that one. Technological knowledge, this also seems right, hold that one. Quantities is not correct. Perseverance, not correct. Technological perseverance, not the right combination. Now, have they given the options? Thinking, now we'll, let us assume it is technological know-how. How many options with the B? Two options. Then what is the second one, C? What is C? Critical thinking skills, seems right, hold that one. What is the next one, F? As well as soft skills such as, F is what? Perseverance. Perseverance comes under soft skills. This seems right, but we'll check the other one. What is the other one? BF, critical thinking. Thinking what? Perseverance, not correct. So what is the answer? The fourth option, technological know-how, critical thinking, skills, and perseverance. Have you got it? Shall I move on to the next one? Question number 25. When countries don't invest in good education and health to build human capital, it puts successive generations, especially the poorest, at a severe disadvantage. Underline the word exacerbate, means make something worse, bad to worse, bad to worse. Exacerbate what? Inequalities, that seems right. Forgets, not correct, threatens, not correct, desires, not correct, aspirations, not a verb. Now we'll go with that one. Which option says that? A. Second option and fourth option, two are there. What is the second one? Exacerbates inequalities that already exist and what? If you take B, B is what? Aggravate what? And aggravate to create instability, is that right? No. Then go to the next option. D is what? Threatens to create instability, this seems right. And what is the last one? F, when rising, aspirations are met with frustration instead of opportunities. So answer is quite obvious. What is the answer? The fourth option is the answer, right? The rise of digital platform marketplaces, what do they do? Integrates, allows, can you use making in this context, market wrong, bringing, hold that one, although even, not relevant. Now we'll see the sentence. The rise of digital platform marketplaces, the impact of technology, bringing the impact of technology to reach or allows the impact of technology to reach. What is the other option? Making the impact of technology. a bit difficult to decide. We'll see the other words. What is the other one? Technology to reach more people more quickly than ever before. Then what is the next one? It's very difficult. I'll use a hard copy. I'm not able to change. What is the question number? 25. The rise of digital platform marketplaces. First one we have considered. Now the second one, to reach more people more quickly than ever before, then let us assume bringing economic opportunity to millions who don't live in industrialized countries, or what is the next one? Even in the industrial areas of the developing world. Now we'll go with the fifth option. I'll read out. Please cross-check. What is the fifth option? The rise of digital platform marketplaces, B, allows the impact of technology to reach more people more quickly than ever before, then what? Bringing economic opportunity to millions who don't live in industrialized countries, or even in industrial areas of the developing. So answer is the fifth option. Now the last five questions, again, very difficult based on the time factor, based on the context, especially the first one. Have you read the instructions? So what are these questions about? One part in bold is correct. Remaining four parts, three are not correct. Only one is correct. So please listen very carefully. However, he deliver. Use your grammar knowledge. It should be either past or present, but deliver is not at all correct. So it should be, just add the letter delivers. However, he delivers the construction of a sort of, no error there. Half boat, how does he deliver? Upturned, then you have to use not upturned, please change it to upturned, perhaps a boat, masquerade, it means act like a shade. Here you cannot say masquerade. Masquerading as a shelter, acting like a shelter. Please change masquerade to masquerading. However, he delivers the construction of a sort of half boat, upturned, perhaps a boat, masquerading as a shelter. Now, which part doesn't have an error? Which one? Third option, D. That's right. I'm giving the correct options, so easy for you to make out, but you respond. Question number 27. The move follows the ongoing debate to various parts of the world or in various parts of the world. Change to in. In various parts of the world, including India, on tackling, debate on what? Debate on tackling. Change tackle to tackling. Spread of fake information on the platform owned by social media, networked or network? Now, which part is correct? Various parts of the world, including India. B is correct. The amendments also allow SEBI to act against entities that furnish false or incomplete or incompletion. Please change that one. False or incomplete information in the regulator or to the regulator. Hope you guys are listening. To the regulator. Earlier, it could act only whether the. Whether is not correct, change it to if. Earlier, it could act only if the entity did not furnish any information. Now, which part doesn't have an error? First part. The amendments also allow SEBI to act. What is the answer? First option is the answer. This is again very difficult based on biology background. During fasting, chitin is removed from the lipid droplets, and this ensures they don't reach the endoplasmic reticulum, neither are they secreted into the blood. There I'm not convinced, but now you have got two errors. You have to decide one more. What is that one? endoplasmic reticulum, neither are. Does it sound right? Please mark it wrong. So which part has an error? D has an error. Now based on that, what is the answer? They secreted into the blood, but not a clear sentence, and that too based on biology background. Chitra chose to share, again, I will read out because it's not at one place. Chitra chose to share her personal journey of learning. Please underline learning, assimilation, disseminating, parallel expression. Learning, disseminating, then it should be what? Assimilating, please correct it. Chitra chose to share her personal journey of learning, assimilating, and disseminating. Underline the word disseminate. Spreading, it means what? Spreading. Disseminating the choreographic process with video clippings to or of her works. Of, not to. Video clipping of her works. Now, which part is correct? D is correct. Choreographic process with. This is really a tough paper. I got headache, frankly speaking, explaining this. Two reasons. One reason.